Hello and welcome to the second section, Independence, Simplifying Joint Distributions. In the previous section, we saw the importance of joint probability distributions, but then we also saw that it can easily get out of hand given the number of required parameters to represent a joint probability distribution. So here we want to use the power of independence, statistical independence, to show how we can reduce the number of parameters. Consider the COVID mask social distancing example. Now we had this joint probability distribution of P of C, MD, which we can write it down as a multiplication of P of C condition on M and D times P of M and D. This is by the definition of conditional probability. If you just take this as the two of M and D as the one that you want to condition on, then just imagine that mask and social distancing, M and D here, are statistically or probabilistically, or also it is said, mutually independent. So, and it is denoted by M, this notation here, perpendicular to D. This means that P of M and D, the joint probability distribution, can be written as a multiplication of the probability of each of them. Now, if this holds, then we can write down the above multiplication as in this form, where instead of P of M and D, we have the multiplication. So, but what is the effect on the number of parameters? Here you can see that instead of 7 that we had before, now we will have 2 to the power of 2 for this conditional independence. Remember, 2 for M, 2 for D, which is 4, and then 2 minus 1 for C, which is still 4, and then 1 for P of M and 1 for P of D. In total, it will be 6. So we had 1 fewer parameters. And this simple example is to exhibit the importance of independence. Independencies can reduce the number of parameters. Now, a little recap for those of you who may not recall statistical independence. Given random variables X and Y, we say that they are independent, and denoted in this way, if P of X and Y equals to P of X times P of Y. Or equivalently, we say P of X condition on Y equals to P of X, meaning that if we provide the external variable Y, it does not add any information to the probability of X. Or the other way around, P of Y given X equals to P of Y. So knowing X does not provide any more information on Y. It doesn't change the distribution of Y. So then when we can say that they are not independent, well, it is true that they are not independent if this condition is violated for any value of Y, or this one, for example. So for example, if you can find two values of Y, say Y1 and Y2, such that this condition is violated, meaning that the probability of X condition on the value Y1 does not equal to the probability of X condition on the value of Y2. This is sufficient to say that the two, X and Y, are not independent. Good. Let's get back to our close to real world example, COVID example with 12 variables. Now, if we assume that all 12 random variables are mutually independent, meaning that, for example, C is independent of M, C is independent of D, and C all the way to C independent of allergy, and then M is independent of social distancing, and U and O and F all the way to A, and so on until R and A also independent. Everything is independent of everything else, okay? Then the joint probability distribution can be written as the multiplication of the probability of each of these variables. Now, how many variables this is? The number of parameters for this joint probability distribution is 1, right? This is a binary variable. We only need one parameter for it, plus 1, all the way. Everything will be 1 except for season, which is 3, because it's 4 minus 1. So it will be 11 plus 3, 14. What was the previous one? It was 8,000. That is a dramatic reduction in the number of parameters. And I hope this can show you how powerful can be the identifying independence relationships between the variables. Now, so to conclude here, I want to say exploring statistical independence is like, has given us this idea that independency can reduce the number of parameters. However, independence is not ubiquitous. And the reason is, for example, the independence assumption in the COVID problem may be wrong. For example, people who wear masks may not also abide by social distancing because they may think that they are safe when they put a mask. Some may believe so, some may not believe so. It can be different. So it's not generally true, perhaps, that the two are independent. And this means that our previous assumption, our dramatic reduction in the number of parameters in the previous slide does not work, right? We cannot assume that everything is independent of everything else. And then the question is, what now? Which we will cover in the next video.